good to feel loved and not have to run to a man for it, but to have these two young men who look up to me, love me, and they hold me accountable.
Right? That's not the question.
They had a taste of a lot of different sticks and candy.
Tanya got the hell out of town, so she took the first thing smoking back to Toronto.
She never came back.
She never came back, baby. She was like,
she wasn't by herself.
Any eye candy, but this cop is saying you have all the answers.
They had fun.
Yeah, a lot of fun.
They, exactly, just to clarify.
They
okay. It's not a secret, is it?
Okay, all right. You had some, shall we say, interactions this last season with a couple ladies, including Kenya and Candy. Where do you and Kenya stand right now? Where would you say your relationship is?
I stand to the left of the couch on this stage, and she stands to the right, well, sits to the right. And I, Candy, I apologize too. I think that we will get over, you know, the bump that we went through, and we're good. It's just a work in progress. I mean, it's a lot to handle on Marlo, and right now I'm so happy because I just feel it's Marlo's time right now, and I just want anyone around me who can celebrate me. So it's like I'm not looking for acceptance. I'm not looking for your apology. I'm just doing me, but want to be the best at doing me and still not be rude.
Yes. Anything to add to that?
No.
I can appreciate it. How is Cindy and...
I just want to say one thing. Did I give you... I just still have to ask the question because I never really got an answer. Did I give you a hard time or did you try to pull a hard time from me? I'm just still, because I don't know what I did to you specifically. Do the people want to know? I just want to know.
Listen, Drew, once again, here you go. We both said we were going to try to lie. You texted me and said you wanted an olive branch, right? Once again, off camera. Yesterday, you were like, let's, and then you come on here and you bring in the energy. I'm trying to give you positive energy, baby. Let's be positive. Stop that.
Positivity.
Let's be positive.
Yes, and after
For whatever reason, we ended up having a hard time. I didn't want to bring it to you.
But there was
you didn't
never
bring
an
it
issue.
To me, so we had a hard time. That's just
there
the reality
was never
of it.
An issue.
But I don't have an issue.
Thank you.
I don't have an issue.
Say they know where I was coming from. Not throwing shade to you, but coming from my upbringing, a lot of doors have opened for me just because of my appearance.
Okay, can we go back to that fire question? You agree?
Thank you. Thank you for the ones that are being honest and understand what I'm seeing.
Oh, her presence makes the doors open wide.
They do.
When she steps up.
I mean, you guys saw it on
in other countries, but it doesn't happen here in the United States.
I understand
now.
This is Marlo's world, darling.
Thank you for explaining. I get it now. Thank you.
You're right. No one knows me in New York. No one.
All right.
It's not a lot of delusion on the stage, right?
You do sound delusional.
Anyway, so BravoCon happened, and Candy and Phaedra, one of the things Jay have on here that I found very interesting, because Jay wrote down a few notes that I kind of vetted through and was like, you know what, do I want this, do I want this, do I want this? A lot of it I really didn't want, but a lot of it
probably.
I did want. Huh?
I said, probably.
Oh, probably.
Right.
But no, seriously, one thing that you did write down is Candy and Phaedra were in the same building after being years separated, years apart from each other. I believe they have been in the same room with each other in the past after this situation. I think that they both were at Cynthia's wedding, if I'm not mistaken.
Phaedra's coming too.
She is coming.
I would have preferred kind of like 24 years before I saw her again.
Well, she is coming.
So I don't think this is the only time they've been in the room together since, or the first time since.
I'm not sure. I'm sure they probably have been at events together.
Right, but I was just gagging at the fact that they were facing each other. I was really gagging at that, like Phaedra and Candy facing each other. I'm very surprised Candy didn't get up and mollywop that hoe.
Now, Kenya, I'm going to tell you where you lose cool points at. When you went in and let half on Phaedra and talking about her teeth would be on the ground. Bitch, I wish you would have looked like you would have jumped at that reunion, bitch. Candy would have dove on your ass. No, God, honey, let me tell you something. Candy is about as hood as they come. And she would have just kicked it all in your ass. And I'm gonna tell you another person who the dove on your back too. NeNe Leakes might not fuck with Phaedra, but I'm gonna tell you one thing I love and respect about that goddamn NeNe Leakes, and that's why I live.
Cause Candy will.
Right, we know that. Portia is not returning. Drew advocates hard for Portia at BravoCon. I don't know how many times she said on a panel that she is advocating for Portia to make a return.
Kenya, the people want to know your answer.
I just want to say I would love to see Portia come back. Okay. I miss her so much. And I'm with the rest of the ladies, you know, I think.
I want Portia to come back. I don't even fuck with Portia like that, but her and Candy done got on good terms, so I want her to come back.
Right. And I feel like if Candy can forgive Portia, then why can't you forgive Phaedra?
No.
It's weird to me that she can't really forgive Phaedra.
No, because number one, the thing is, Portia. Candy was running to Phaedra about the stuff that she said about Candy.
How I am about my dang on husband.
I don't know if anybody's lying.
Phaedra, she said I had a sex dungeon. You know, if I had one, I would tell everybody about it because I don't care. Doesn't really matter. It's the part.
Phaedra, you know, it took everything out of me not to choke the shit out this bitch. She was talking directly to Phaedra. Phaedra didn't stand up and say, but you know what, Candy? I was the one that told Portia this information because somebody told me. So at no point, Phaedra let this whole thing ride until the reunion, until Portia aired her ass out. Why you ain't been said something if you such a loyal person or you such a good friend? Same way she was sneakily talking about Candy was fucking Shamia because they thought the cameras wasn't recording them. They were trying to whisper and say that. But they caught her ass.
Talk about that.
You know how Candy.
You what?
Yeah, they are. Yeah, Candy best friend. Wait, Candy is you. You a motherfucking liar.
You knew that?
They are really close.
But you think that too?
Yeah, I mean, you yes. She close to both of them.
She doing both.
Her and her.
She doing both.
She was being sneaky with that, but I mean, Candy is not perfect.
No, she's not, but I'm just
saying. The
bitch
come off as perfect because she damn near. Candy don't be really doing nothing really for real.
I don't think she did anything to Phaedra. I do not think she did a thing to Phaedra. If Phaedra wanted to take her getting them damn motorbikes and shit, too. She ain't did shit to Phaedra.
Ain't that what she said at the reunion?
And then why Nene said, what did I do for you to do me like that? What did I do to you?
I just had a conversation with my sister. She told me everything that you did. You need to own up to your wrongdoing. And you did something that was very wrong. What was your purpose of sitting somewhere trying to film with my half-sisters? What if I sat up on the show and filmed with your mama or with your aunt or your ex-boyfriend to try to bring or do you harm? We all work on this show together. I'm not trying to take anybody out. And I ain't got to like your ass, but I ain't gonna go sit and try to be dirty and bring up your past. You do have a past. Everybody sitting up here has a past. I would never sit here and do no bullshit like that. And you were wrong. Now, we got past it. The Lord says to forgive, and I forgive you, but I will never forget that you did that to me. Don't get it twisted.
What I'm saying to
you is something that was absolutely dirty. You and Sheree them, and probably Kim with her big ass wig went out and sat with them trying to be low down and dirty. But see, you never can win when you're dirty, honey. You never can win. What the f*** did I do to you for you to do that? Nothing. Nothing.
For some reason, I don't care. This crazy thing thinking everybody's coming against you, NeNe.
Not a damn thing. You ain't got to do nothing to Phaedra. She just gonna come for your neck when she feel like it. Scorpio,
right. Right. But Drew has to Drew kinda has to advocate for Portia coming back because that is her boss. Who's that?
I'm trying to see what's Phaedra.
That is her boss. So I mean I'm not surprised that she's advocating for Portia to come back. That's not a huge surprise to me. It was just a blessing in disguise.